And welcome back, folks. Welcome back to another special video. Welcome to this year's New Year video. And before I do anything else, I wish all of you who are watching this right now a happy 2018. To those who have watched these kind of videos in the previous years, you know the drill by now, but for those who don't, I'm going to explain what we are going to do. We're going to play a game, and I'm going to say some mildly interesting things about the last year and what happened here at my channel. So the game that we are going to play is Downwell, and I hope that this is going to go down well, because the last time I tried to record this, OBS crashed, so I just hope it doesn't this time. So Downwell, which would be this very game that we are playing right now, was released in October 2015. It is actually quite remarkable because it was developed by only one guy, Ojiro Fumoto, who goes by the handle MOPIN_ on Twitter. And this guy has sort of an interesting biography. He didn't really start out as a game developer. He started out as an opera singer. He wanted to pursue a career in opera singing at the Tokyo University of Arts, but decided that actually he didn't want to do that, and instead he wanted to create games. And the way he got into making games was just, well, by making them. So he did some basically personal game marathons, where he created a game within a week. And he did this 13 times before he created this game. This game was probably not created in a week, but it started out as one of these projects. It was his 13th game in a week project. And yeah, the rest is history. This game was quite successful. It was published by Devolver Digital, and it's actually one of, it's actually the only game that I've ever played on a mobile device and came back to it. This game has sort of it's minimalistic, but not in an annoying way. It's not shallow. It's a game basically like Tetris. You can play it again and again and again, and it doesn't get boring. There's always a challenge for you and some enjoyment to be had. So we're going to play this game. I'm going to say some things about this channel. We can select several styles on my mobile device. So I played this game mostly on my phone, in fact. There I have unlocked all of the styles that you can choose. But I still think that the regular style is the best, so we're going to pick that. The gameplay is very simple. The main idea of this game is that you keep falling down. Now you may ask, well, how is that the game? Well, first of all, there are enemies. So it seems that in every video game the easiest way to make a game is to have enemies that you can kill and that will kill you. So the difficulty in this game arises through the fact that you have only a limited number of health points, and every time you touch one of the enemies, or more specifically, every time you touch a red part of one of the enemies, you will get hit. So I can't jump on these slugs because they are red, but I could jump on that fellow over there. And I can jump on this turtle. And more generally, I can jump on anything that is, yeah, not completely red. There are ways to upgrade your health slot. You see this, so it says 4 of 4, so that's 4 health points out of 4 possible points. But below that bar is, that health bar is a white bar consisting of 4 segments, and the first segment is in white. And if we collect 3 more segments, so 3 more health points, we get a health upgrade, so that the red bar would read 4 out of 5 or 5 out of 5. So and then there are also these caverns, which are sort of a different game almost, in which, in the sense that here there is no time. And there are no enemies. However, there are certain challenges, bonus challenges that you can perform in order to get more of these red crystals. Yeah. So the main thing that you do is you fall down. The second thing that you do is you collect these red crystals. And this game is, this game is, as I've already mentioned, is very good in my opinion. Not just in my opinion, but in other people's opinions too. I would even go so far as to say that this game is, to at least the modern mobile gaming area, is what is Tetris to, well, the maybe late 80s, early 90s, the Game Boy era. Because it's the only mobile game that I can play for. It's the only mobile game that I can keep coming back to. Okay, after every completed stage, you have the possibility to choose an upgrade. I think we're going to go with maybe this one. Okay, 2017. Yeah, 2017 was a bit of a slow year. In the sense that at least regarding this channel, in the sense that I didn't upload a lot of videos, which is actually only halfway true, because the beginning of this year started out actually quite productive. Most notably, I did a game marathon in, I think, May, or yeah, I think it was May. On the occasion of the Ludum Dare Game Marathon. Sorry, on the occasion of the Ludum Dare Game Jam. So, and my marathon consisted of me playing basically two games submitted to this game jam every day. one chosen by me and one chosen at random. And yeah, I think I produced some 45 videos in total, just for that marathon alone. And then I also started a new Let's Play in the beginning of the year. But then after May, there weren't a lot of videos on this channel. I'm going to try to maybe explain why. Which is not that easy, because I myself, to be honest, don't really know why. I can't reconstruct why there was that little progress. despite this being a slow year in a sense, I did complete two Let's Plays, namely the Let's Play of Fallout and the Let's Play of Broken Sword, the Shadow of the Templars. Something that I forgot actually. When you kill a lot of enemies in a row without touching the ground, you can sort of basically get a bonus for doing that. Okay, here is one of the challenges that I mentioned. So the goal here would be to touch all of these three torches without touching the ground, and this should be possible in theory. But I'm not sure whether I'm going to be able to do that. Okay. I only got two of the three. But it should be possible to get all three of them, and then you'll get a bonus. So I completed Fallout and Broken Sword. And I started the Let's Play of Bioforge, which I was very excited initially to play, and I'm still excited to play. However, turned out that this is actually the most difficult game to record that I've ever recorded. And so I stopped. So basically, the problem was, or is still, that I need to record this game in using the in-game, not the in-game, but using the recording capabilities of DOSBox, which is actually fine by itself. However, DOSBox records the game not as you see it, but as it should be. So basically, and you notice that we got a upgrade for that. So DOSBox records games as they should look, and if you get a slowdown in DOSBox, you will see that slowdown, but not in the recording. And as a result of that, whenever there's a slowdown in the recording, there will be a mismatch in there will be some synchronizing problem between the audio and the audio that I record, so basically what I'm saying, and the video and the audio of the game. So that's the reason why I stopped recording this game, but I will hopefully sort out these technical difficulties actually this week. Okay, so I started a new Let's Play. I had this marathon in May, but there were more special videos this year than in every other year before. For first of all, we had the New Year video of 2017, which I try to maintain as a tradition. But we also had an April Fool's video, which, in case you haven't seen it, which you probably haven't because only two people have watched it so far, was intended to be, it's an April Fool's joke, and it was basically intended as a parody, where I pretend to play, where I play Tetris and pretend basically to not know what Tetris is about, and I completely miss and overinterpret the meaning of Tetris. And I myself, I'm actually quite fond of what I accomplished there. I think it's one of my best videos. It was certainly one of the most difficult or the most labor-intensive videos I ever did. Not so much for the video itself, but for the fact that I not only did a parody in the video itself, I made a little intro to this video, which was very time-consuming to make, which was way too time-consuming to be able to justify, but that exactly was the point, to have so a video, some content that is not very good, and then this completely overproduced, hilarious intro video. There were several live streams, in fact. Scheiße. Live streams. I did a live stream of Antumbra here on YouTube. I did a live stream of the game Samurai, which was on Twitch. I did a live stream of Scheiße. I did the Halloween special where I did a live stream of the game D, which was notable because it was done in real time. I mean, of course, every live stream is in real time, but the game D must be completed in real time, in the sense that there's a time limit of 1 hour. You need to complete the game in 1 hour, and yeah, so that was basically, so it was appropriate to do that as a live stream. So a live stream of D, and a video of Monster Bash as a special video for Halloween. Then I did a live stream of the game's Samurai, which is a very interesting game from the 80s. Then I did a live stream of the game Grand Theft Vampus, which is actually not a game that you can download per se. I mean, you can download it, but It's actually only it's available on my GitHub account. So it's basically just an example, an exercise from a textbook on programming. But I decided to play it anyway. I decided to play it anyway. Scheiße. Okay. Yeah. So that was most of the qualitatively that was basically what happened here in 2017. In numbers, it's actually the story is a little bit different. In the sense that even though I didn't upload a lot of videos, surprisingly, the number of views and the watch time increased. Okay, so in numbers, the watch time increased from 46,919 hours to 45,172. So compared to 2016, there were 45,000 hours of people watching my stuff, which is insane. Unless you remember to divide this number by the people of by the number of views, which would be there were 17,083 views in 2016, and in the last year, in 2017, there were 28,196 views. Well, I think this is in hours. I'm not. Maybe this is in minutes, because yeah, maybe this is actually in minutes and not in hours. That would make more sense. Okay, there were in 2016 there were 26 comments. In 2017, I got 55 comments, which probably is because of the Ludum Dare game marathon, which resulted in some interesting conversations with some game developers, with some game developers. I actually got some small conversations going. The number of likes increased from 90 in 2016 to a whopping 176 in 2017, which is interesting. Whereas the dislikes only increased to 22, whereas compared to 13 dislikes in the year 2016. Scheiße. So there was a lot of activity in the beginning of the year, and then it's sort of petered out. The reason for this was that I took two, let's say vacations, which were each about a month long, in June and in September, I think. And basically I took some time off from my, I mean, from my usual surroundings and went to a place where I could devote my whole time to working on something that I've been working on for years and years, and I've finally completed this year. So it's basically, yeah, it was a work week vacation. So this took 2 months out of the year, and then there were other reasons why I didn't upload that many videos. First of all, I noticed very much that when you take a break from things, it's hard to get back into it. And YouTube recording is no exception to this. Just the way people work. It's much easier to do something if you keep doing it all the time. And the second reason was, at least with BioForge, there are technical problems that sort of shifted or prevented me from recording. But nonetheless, it was still a quite successful year. And also personally, it was a successful year as I managed to complete the thing that I have been working on for so long. I finally managed to complete that. Which going forward means that I'm I have more freedom now to pursue other things. So that's basically all that I wanted to say about 2017. So to summarize, it was a overall very successful year, a bit mixed, but in the end it was a success. Now the new year, I of course have, like most people probably, have made some New Year's resolution. I have made some New Year resolution, of course. Some personal ones, as well as some resolutions regarding this channel, and I don't think I'm going to talk about my personal resolutions, but I am going to talk about the resolutions regarding this channel. The first thing that I want to say is that I want to assure you that this channel is not going to go away, so I will renew my efforts to put some interesting content up on this channel. I will also, and most importantly, try to get back to a consistent upload schedule. And I promise to you that I will complete at least these... I will complete 3 Let's Plays this year. The Bioforge Let's Play, the Zelda Let's Play, and the System Shock Let's Play. I mean, with the System Shock Let's Play, it's... That's not much of a resolution, since it's almost finished anyway, and I didn't have a lot of problems recording this game. With Bioforge, it means that I'm going to fix these technical issues by the end of this week, hopefully. And with Zelda, it just means that I need to get back to recording it. I will keep it. I think I will keep it that way, that I will record Zelda only one video on for the Sunday slot. But I will, as soon as one of the other Let's Plays is finished, I will go back to recording Zelda also on during the week, which means I'm going to record it. I'm going to record it 3 times a week. I mean, 3 videos a week. So, yeah. Those are my promises, and I may also do another Ludum Dare marathon. And I also may do more streaming, and maybe some other videos, of another style, or maybe I'm going to experiment a little bit with this channel and try something new, something different. Okay, can get one. Okay. Shit. Okay, so that's... I think that's actually everything that I wanted to say. I, of course, also would like to... say some... Would like to use this video to express my gratitude to you, to anyone who, has commented on one of my videos or just enjoyed the content. Thank you for appreciating, these things that I have created. I mean, as I said several times, this is first of all a hobby for me. I'm not under the delusion that I'm going to get rich or famous with this channel, but it's just something that I enjoy doing, and I would probably keep doing it even if nobody would care, but... Oh, okay. Now I need to pay attention. But if people care, it's of course that much more, more interesting. I actually, Getting this, there, sorry, I'm a bit distracted right now because, I didn't get this far, actually, didn't get this far in the game, maybe one or two times, so, I'm not very familiar with this level, yeah, but, I said basically everything that I wanted to say, except, yeah, thanking you for appreciating my content, and I very much appreciate feedback. So, if you have anything to comment, please do so. But of course, you don't have to. You're free to appreciate the content, and yeah, just as I enjoy doing, I mean, recording these videos. Okay. Scheiße. Okay, we need some air. Okay. Why did this not fill up my air? I almost made it. Okay. Well, I think that's a good point to stop this video, or to end this video rather. Yeah, I wish all of you, to all of my viewers, to all of my subscribers, and to anyone who is watching this video right now, a happy 2018, and I wish that all of the resolutions that you made for yourself, you can keep. And even if you're not able to do that, even if you break these resolutions, just remember that you can always start anew. There's nothing preventing you from starting again. Yeah, like in this game, except, yeah, eventually you will die and then maybe you can't try again, but as long as you are breathing, you can just try one more time. Yeah, so happy 2018, and until next time, folks, until then, and I, by God, I hope this did record.